Hello friends, welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. In the previous episode, we had talked about the cosmos and the pure energy of soul. And in that episode, it was very clear that the whole cosmos is within the soul energy or within the pure energy of consciousness, not vice versa. Because generally people think that the soul is within us, right? Okay, and that is why they are not able to experience the reality of soul. And I would not call it experience, but I would call it the direct perception of that reality of the soul or the pure energy of consciousness. So friends, one thing should be clear to all of you. When I say pure energy of consciousness, okay, that is our soul, Chaitanya Atma, that is soul. And the cosmos, okay, which is already there, okay, in that energy, within that energy, right? So the system of these two things, right? The pure energy of consciousness, okay, which is the energy of soul or soul, you can say, okay, and the whole cosmos, okay. So this is the eternal system, right? This system does not know any time or space. There is no sense of time or space, okay, within this two system. Now, if we come within the cosmos, then the act of experiencing starts, right? And before the act of experiencing, okay, the experiencer is created. Although according to Jai Krishnamurti, the experiencer is the experience. This is the same flow of energy, right? So this system starts evolving within the cosmos, right? And this is totally imaginary. Why I call it imaginary? Okay, because it has the system of experiencer, the experience, and the act of experiencing, right? And experience is time, and experience is space. Okay, so our experience of time and space is basically, it is only because of the experience, okay, that we keep having all kinds of experiences, okay, and all these experiences collectively create, you can say, the dead experiencer, okay. Why dead? Okay, because it is no more valid. Okay, it is not alive. Okay, something has gone by, passed. Okay, and but still there is the experiencer behind it. Okay, so this whole affair of experience and the experiencer, okay, is totally imaginary, totally time bound, right? That is why I call it imaginary world. So the world of experience is nothing but imaginary, pure imaginary, right? So what is eternal then? What is not touched by time and space? The system of pure energy, pure consciousness, right? And the cosmos, the pure cosmos. Okay, now this must be clear, I hope, to all of you. Now the question is, in this imaginary world, in the world of experiencing, okay, the world of experience and the experiencer, how can one get in touch with the pure energy of soul, which is outside of it? Imaginary world is contained within the cosmos, and the whole cosmos is contained within the pure energy of the soul. Now the question is, how can one get the experience of, not experience, how can one get in touch with that energy, the pure energy of soul, okay, which is outside of it, or which does not touch the imaginary world at all, Nowadays, all kinds of Mahatmas, spiritual persons, okay, they keep talking about the experience of soul is within us. Okay, we are already in the imagined world. We are already in the world of experiencer. Experience and experiencer. So, to my mind, this is not possible to have the glimpse of that pure energy. Okay, we are in it. Okay, that is not within us. Okay, this point should be very, very clear. Only then we can move forward, right? Now, one important thing, okay, in this episode, I would like to highlight the person who has got in touch with that pure energy of consciousness or the energy of soul or the soul. Okay, what are the characteristics of that person living in this world? What do you think, friends? If you have any idea of any characteristic, please leave your comment in the comment box. But in this episode, I would like to highlight on three or four characteristics of that person who has, you can say, the direct experience or the direct perception of that energy. Okay, and in that energy, mind you, friends, in that energy, there is no system of the experiencer or the doership or the experience. Okay, these systems is not there in that pure energy. Okay, that is pure energy, untouched by time and space. So if the person has got that kind of thing in his life, or he has tasted that pure energy, okay, what are the characteristics of that person? To my mind, there are three main important characteristics of that person. The first is that person, whatever is the situation in his life, whatever problem he is facing, immediately he will get into his real nature. Real nature means the experience of or the perception of that pure energy of soul, that pure energy of consciousness. Okay, and he will be relaxed. So he always remains untouched by any kind of experience, by any kind of problem. Right? This is the first characteristics or first attribute of that person. Okay. He will be just like the lotus flower, okay, who lives in the mud, okay, but it remains untouched by the mud. Okay, so this is the first very important characteristic or attribute of that person. Second characteristic is, you see, to that person, the nature, okay, involve that person very much or more than normal human beings. Okay, the nature offers more and more problems for that person. Okay, the nature wants him to be involved with the nature, with the affair of natures. Okay, affair of nature is what? Okay, sometimes it is very pleasant, sometimes it is very sorrowfulness. Okay, so sometimes there is pain, sometimes there is happiness, unhappiness. Okay, so this is the nature of the intrinsic characteristic of the nature, right? So the nature will offer more and more problems for that person, right? I don't know why, but this is the characteristic of nature, okay, for that person. So second attribute. Third attribute is the fact that the person will always be in the state of bliss. Okay, what I mean by being in the state of bliss is no problem will ever touch that person. For that person, there is no problem. Okay, but since he or she is living in this world, okay, with his body, with his mind, with his intellect, okay, there will be problem, okay, but he knows from inside, from deep inside, from his heart, that his seed is that pure energy, that energy of soul, okay, so he will always remain unperturbed, okay. For the general people, okay, he will look perturbed, disturbed, okay, for some time, okay, but ultimately, okay, he will remain unperturbed, peaceful, okay. So these are the three characteristics or three attributes of that person, right. The fourth characteristics is, which is also very important, when that person dies, what happens? Because these attributes we can understand, because we can have this experience, we can relate to that person, because we are also alive, he is also alive, we are also in this world, he is also in this world, right? So we can relate, okay, these attributes of that person. But when he or she dies, who has the perception of that pure energy? What happens to that person? Friends, when he or she dies, he becomes free of everything and he gets into that state from where he does not come into any kind of system in this whole cosmos. Why, friends? Because he has no system at all, right? The system using which he gets into this cosmos or any system in the cosmos, that system is broken down completely, okay? He has no sense of body, he has no sense of his mind, he has no sense of his intellect, right? All kinds of attachments has been broken down. It is not found. Simply it is not found, okay? Because he does not live in any kind of experience. And it is experience only that binds that pure energy. So that pure energy is bound by your experience, the sense of I and the experience of that I, right? And this system has been totally fallen flat. It has been totally thrashed. He has no experience left anymore. Okay, that is why without experience, okay, he will not be able to come into or fit into any system in this whole cosmos. Okay, this is the fourth attribute of that person. Now, I would like Sharmaji also, from the yogic science point of view, to talk about the characteristics of the person who has that experience, okay, in Hindi, so that the Hindi speaking or Hindi understanding, you know, the person, those who understand Hindi, okay, they can also relate, okay, what I have said, okay, in this episode. Over to Sharmaji. Sharmaji, aise vyakti ke bare mein bataiye jisko ki jis pure energy ki humne baat ki thi iske pehle episode mein, jisko ki atmgyan hai, hai na, wo is sansar mein wo bhi rehta hai, hum bhi rehte hain, theek hai? तो उसके रहने में और हमारे रहने में क्या फर्क है, है ना, क्या लक्षण है उसके?
योगिक साइंस के माध्यम से अगर हम इस पर विचार भी करें या अनुभव की बात करें, तो इसमें ये चीज आती है कि सबसे पहले जो हमें शास्त्र और संत महात्मा अंदर बाहर बताते हैं कि अंदर से आत्मा प्रकट होगी जो ध्यान भजन करेंगे, बाहर से बोलते हैं कि नहीं जी हम दान दक्षिणा करेंगे तो बाहर से हमें आशीर्वाद मिलेगा तो आत्मा प्रकट होगी, फिर हमें पता चलता है कि नहीं जी ये तो करते करते जिंदगी बीत गई, आत्मा तो सामने आई नहीं, तो उसके बाद में पता चला कि सबसे जो मेन चीज़ है वो किसी ने नहीं बताई, और उसमें ये है कि अपना जो वजूद है, जो अस्तित्व है हमारा, वो हम कभी नहीं हटा पाए, और अस्तित्व अगर मिट जाता तो अंदर बाहर से प्रकट नहीं, अंदर बाहर की गणना तो हमने करी क्योंकि हम तो हैं ही अंदर में, तो हम अंदर बाहर की गणना तो हमने अपने आप करी है। तो वो सवाल इस बात का कि उसके जब उसे प्रत्यक्ष हो जाती है ये जिसे हम आत्मा कहते हैं, जो चेतन एनर्जी है, जब प्रत्यक्ष हो जाती है तो उसका कार्य कार्य है, वो कार्य प्रत्यक्ष हो जाता है, जो रचना है वो उसका परिणाम है। तो परिणाम जो है वो तो काल्पनिक है। अब सवाल इस बात का आता है कि अगर उसके लक्षण ऐसे क्या हैं, तो मैं उसमें ये कहना चाहूँगा कि एक तो वो इतनी गति से जो समस्याएं आती हैं सब पे आती हैं, ब्रह्मांड में रह रहे तो आना चाहिए, तो वो उसमें इतनी गति होती है कि जिसको हम बता सकते कि वो जो समस्या सामने आई है वो कितनी जल्दी वहाँ जा करके अपनी जगह पे पहुँचे और वहाँ जा करके वो समस्या का समाधान नहीं, ज्यों की त्यों समस्या वहाँ उसे जा करके शांत हो गई है, बस और कुछ नहीं है। ये जिसकी समस्या है वो जाने, जिसका क्लेश है वो जाने, ब्रह्मांड में तो क्लेश रहते हैं। हम हमेशा जो है फ्री के फ्री, तो फ्री वो बहुत तेजी से वो फ्री हो जाता है, नंबर एक। नंबर दूसरी बात, उसको ये ब्रह्मांड में हमेशा एक चाहे आप कहिए संकेत मिलता है क्या है, तो वो एक लाइट जो हमने देखी थी कि वो जो चल रही थी, जो प्रकाश दे रही थी, वो यहाँ पे एक लाइट हमेशा बड़ी छोटी भी चलती, बड़ी भी चलती, दूरी तक चलती है, वो उसको हमेशा एक दो दिन में तो देखना लाजमी है और दिखती है। तो आज जबकि आत्माएं तो पूरी भरी पड़ी, मगर ऐसी कोई प्रकाशमयी एक ऐसी आत्मा होती है जो वो प्रकाश देती है तेज गति से, तो गतिमान होती है वो, तो वो ये दिखती रहती है। बाकी ये जो जिस तरीके की बात हम विचार करते हैं कि ये चीज होनी चाहिए, ये चीज होनी, इससे उसका कोई लेना देना नहीं होता। वो ठीक है, जैसा जो कुछ है बढ़िया है, मगर वो अपनी ही स्थिति से उबर नहीं पाता। वो उस स्थिति में जहां वो प्रत्यक्ष है उससे वो उबर नहीं पाता। तो ये सबसे बड़ी चीज उसके अंदर होती है कि उबर जाना। तो ये तो ना तो मृत्यु काल के से कोई मृत्यु से कोई मतलब नहीं, इससे कोई मतलब नहीं होता, मगर वो उसे वहां पर वो प्रत्यक्ष ही रहता है। ये उसकी एक चाहे समझो कि ये चीज आ जाती है। और उसमें देखो, अगर आत्मा नहीं प्रत्यक्ष है तब क्या हासिल करोगे? अब प्रत्यक्ष है तब क्या आप हमें बहुत बड़ा एक मिठाई का डब्बा मिल जाएगा कि भैया आत्मा तो प्रत्यक्ष है? कुछ नहीं है, बस इतना ही सी इतनी सी बात है कि वो एक तो बहुत गति में बैग खींचता है, बैग को जाता है, पीछे की तरफ जाता है, जो आगे काल्पनिक है तो पीछे की तरफ असलियत में आता है, तो उसकी रफ्तार बहुत तेज है। ये इतनी गति बता पाना मुश्किल है, क्योंकि शब्द तो बाद में आएगा, उसको पहले पहुंच जाता वो। तो ये चीज मेरे बस की बात नहीं कि
ओके
मैं
ओके
आपको।
फ्रेंड्स, लेट मी समराइज ओके व्हाट शर्मा जी वांट्स टू से। ओके, व्हाट ही इज सेइंग इज वेरी सिंपल। ही इज सेइंग द रियलाइजेशन ऑफ दैट प्योर एनर्जी, द एनर्जी ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस और द सोल सरपासेस ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस, ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड। ओके, द रियलाइजेशन ऑफ दैट एनर्जी इज वेरी वेरी पावरफुल। ओके, एंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट पावर ऑल प्रॉब्लम सीम्स वेरी वेरी यू कैन से वीक, राइट, और वेरी यू कैन से इन्फाइनेटेसिमली स्मॉल। ओके, इट हैज नो वैल्यू एट ऑल। ओके, इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट एनर्जी। ओके, सो इफ एनीबडी हु रियलाइजेस ओके दैट प्योर एनर्जी, ओके प्योरिटी, द प्योरिटी ऑफ यू नो कॉन्शियसनेस और सोल, ओके फॉर हिम ओके देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन हिज लाइफ। ओके, इवन इफ देर आर प्रॉब्लम्स, ओके ही फाउंड्स वेरी इमिडिएटली ओके इन नो टाइम दैट ही इज देयर इन दैट रियलाइजेशन। ओके, सो विद दिस फ्रेंड ओके होपफुली यू विल लाइक दिस एपिसोड एंड द नेक्स्ट एपिसोड ऑल्सो ओके विल टॉक समथिंग अबाउट दिस एनर्जी ऑफ सोल, राइट? सो कीप वॉचिंग। थैंक यू।